I feel like he was a nice balance of both laid back, but then there was the other side that was, you know, ruthlessly driven.
Relaxed, chill, but focused and motivated.
Dedicated, just hungry, visionary.
I moved to Boone in 96 as a freshman going to ASU, and for me, that was the only school I applied to. I just knew the first time that I went to Boone on a college visit, first place we went was Blowing Rock Boulders, and right off the bat met some just of the key folks there, so like Jim Toomey, Ross, which would very soon then connect me to Jack, which is how I met him.
I remember meeting Jack at Joey's barn. And I helped him put the ceiling trusses up. And that was before Jack was older. And
he was just suddenly on the scene climbing. That's what I remember.
I had met Jack, I believe, when I lived in Boone back in somewhere between 92 and 96. And I think he had long dreads at the time.
Of course, when I met Jack initially, he had the full head of dreadlocks. Way into reggae music, all those aspects, right?
I have a little studio. I had a studio in the basement, and he used to come over here, and we would play music. He got really good on our guitar quickly. One love, one heart. Let's get
together. Feel alright. Hear the children cry. Joey's barn and the barn boulders behind there. You know, it's almost like an off the grid where Joey was living, always a collection of characters around there. But directly beside it, over the fence, was an amazing and beautiful collection of boulders. But just some amazing lines. And again, as I think to Jack, I think, you know, some of his biggest contributions to the Boone climbing catalog were there with things like Step and Razor, Under Pressure, which were just legit test pieces out there, which again were like, you know, multiple generations of climbers in Boone have come through and tried those because they're just such just splitter clear beautiful lines.
You know, back to the reggae and music and climbing, though, the Step and Razor, the name came from a Bob Marley song,
Peter Tosh.
Oh, Peter Tosh.
Yeah.
Working on Step and Razor, his Superman project. And his dedication, everybody, nobody else would even work on it. So it's just so far out, this vertical phase, just a little razor. You wanna live, treat me good.
If you wanna live, live, I beg you, treat me good. I'm like a walking razor, don't you watch my size, I'm dangerous.
It's just, yeah, I couldn't even imagine holding on to the first hold forever. Yeah, that just didn't seem possible. But it took, what, 5 years?
In 5 years?
Yeah, like 5 years.
Consistent. And now it's a world-class mortar problem known around the world. Trish Sharma came and did it. Jimmy Webb didn't even get on it when he was here. And right now, honestly, this is one of my main projects. I still haven't done it.
Back in 1999, a friend of mine, Paul Barraza, and I did a four-month tour of the Southeast to film NASCARma. So one of the problems he did in the video was Zen Master. I ended up training in Zen Buddhism for the last 21 years, lived in three different Zen Buddhist monasteries here in the U.S. You know, Zen is a word that comes from the Sanskrit word dhyana or dhyana, which means meditation. When you're on the rock, you can't be doing anything else. You have to be completely focused and concentrated on the activity that you're doing.
Whatever's on your mind, you really have to kind of ignore that and just focus mainly on climbing, or else you're not going to make it.
Focus. He was very good at kind of choosing his moments, right? Whether that's the rest days leading up to it, whether that's the warm-up. He was driven and focused to know himself, you know the strategies and tactics behind it, I feel like, to really like be good at execution. Because, you know, some people you'll see, it's like you almost see their ability, like you should be climbing harder, right? Like you just see how strong they are, but they don't necessarily maybe ever realize that potential. But for someone with Jack, you feel like it's like, yeah, he had kind of that mental and physical combination to really like, yeah, achieve like his limit and push himself really to what, you know, to the max that he could do.
Just that kind of dedication stands out about Jack, and that, you know, he would do the teamwork and part of the crew thing, but he'd also do the lone guy in the woods, putting in the time with the chalk and the working out the moves, and both those sides are really important, I think.
Such a great time to be in Boone because, again, bouldering was coming on the scene, and you know, we were on kind of the leading edge of finding some of these areas and breaking into some of the new grades and FAs there. So, you know, one of the ones I would call out specifically at Lost Cove is Two Pop. Such a simple but just so hard in terms of doing it. Such a classic boulder, you know, kind of had the pure power move, but then also some really technical mantling aspects of it.
Because you got to hold that sway. What's the campus move? You got to hold that sway from that boulder right behind you, and that was tricky. Yeah, that was tricky.
Both got to where we were just flailing off the mantle, but getting up there consistently.
I remember a funny one to Jack, where he just kind of just starts laughing at the mantle and falls off.
Trading turns on a problem like that. Like that's how, you know, that's where you can like build that energy to ultimately, you know, break through. And
that feeling, if you could bottle that, man, that adrenaline, like when you top out, is that feeling is just something amazing, you know. And it takes a long time to get it.
it's hard for me to separate like that moment in time for me and Jack and the friends that we were with. And for me, it was just such a seminal moment, right? It was where the first time I moved away from home. And then, you know, ultimately Jack and the crew we were climbing with, you know, just were such a key part of that story for me, right? So the people that I hung out with, the music that I started to listen to, it was such a seminal moment for me. And again, Jack just, it was a key part of that. So I just really appreciated his friendship during that. Him also pushing me as a climber, right? Again, I mean, it's fun to have that healthy level of competitiveness, you know, when you're trying to push yourself.
Hold on to it, Matt. You got it.
And again, it was awesome to see him. Just, he was, you know, at that point already had a family. Elijah was on the scene as well. It's funny, at that time at 18 or 19, you know, yeah, there's a kid on the scene. It's, you know, he's here and there. But now as a parent, I realize it's like, man, that's challenging. You know, bringing kids to the boulders and, you know, still being like right in the mix with everyone else, and you're hanging out with a bunch of teenagers, you know, running up into the boulders, and such a great, you know, example just to see there. It's like, yeah, having a family and you can still pursue your passions and, you know, support both. So no, it was a great time in my life. Jack was a big part of that. And yeah, it's good to see everyone still doing great and rocking here in 2023.